take a look at this new crazy image taken by James Webb. Where were you on July 12, 2022? Some may have been relaxing at home, engrossed in their own activities, or enjoying video games with friends. Others may have been nursing a broken heart, while some sought solace in the serenity of nature. And then there were those unfortunate souls who were trapped in the monotonous grind of work. Little did anyone know that this seemingly ordinary day held something truly remarkable in store. On this fateful day, a groundbreaking moment occurred as the most powerful telescope to ever grace the heavens was launched into space. Fast forward 1 year and we find ourselves gathered here today to celebrate its first birthday. Excitingly, this magnificent device has a special gift for humanity. An image that will leave you in awe and wonder. Prepare yourself to witness what could possibly be the most breathtaking picture of the month. Join us as we embark on this captivating video journey to feast our eyes on this extraordinary image. It is an occasion that showcases the sheer brilliance of human ingenuity and our insatiable quest to unravel the mysteries of the universe. The image. So here's the image. Wow, where do we even begin with it? There's so much happening here, it's mind-blowing. At first glance, you'll see a whole bunch of red in these cool hexagonal lights that look like spiked stars. And you're totally right, that's exactly what they are. But if you take a closer look, you'll see there's a whole lot more going on. First off, check out those super dark clouds. They look so intense, right? And here's the crazy part. One of those clouds is like pierced by a massive stream of red stuff. And it is shooting out from inside the cloud like a boss. Plus, the edges of the stream are all bright and glowing. How awesome is that? Now let's break it down and really understand what we're looking at here. It's like a puzzle we're solving together. A whole universe packed into one frame. The cloud complex. First things first, let me tell you something. James Webb is never boring. It knows exactly where to look. In this case, the subject of this beautiful cosmic painting is the so-called ophiuchi cloud complex, the closest star forming region to Earth. If you ask me, it's like going to the nursery and seeing all these cute little babies playing and crying, knowing that sooner or later that they will grow up and become men and women with different stories, different eye colors, and different scars. The ophiuchi cloud complex takes its name from the star dominating that region, ophiuchi, located 3 grades north of Antares in the Ophiuchus constellation. Its average distance is just 130 parsecs, or 420 light-years. Morphologically, the cloud complex appears divided into two main clouds, indicated with the abbreviations LDN-1688, which constitutes the major nucleus, and LDN-1689 with a lower mass. Several dark nebulous filaments are connected to both clouds. Thanks to its proximity, this cloud constitutes an interesting field of research on the evolution of low-mass stars and brown dwarfs, as well as a laboratory for the study of chain star formation phenomena. The stars and the circumstellar disks. In the close-up image taken by the Webb telescope, we can clearly see powerful jets shooting out from young stars. These jets collide with the surrounding molecular hydrogen, causing it to light up and appear as red gas. But what is really interesting is that some of the stars in the picture have a distinct shadow around them, which indicates the presence of a circumstellar disk. These disks are like the building blocks of future planetary systems. The young stars at the center of these disks are similar in size to our Sun or even smaller. However, among all the stars in this image, the most massive one is called S1. S1 can be seen in the lower half of the image, surrounded by a glowing cave-like structure. This structure is actually being carved out by the intense winds coming from S1. These winds are so strong that they are shaping the surrounding gas into a distinct shape. The lighter-colored gas around S1 is made up of polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. These are carbon-based molecules that are commonly found in space. They are a vital ingredient for the formation of new stars and planets. Speaking about circumstellar disks, where exactly can you see them? Well, for instance, focus on the top center of the image. There's a star displaying a large, vertically pinched dark shadow. That's its circumstellar disk. Well, what exactly is it? Remember that stars are from dust and gas. After stars form, the remaining dust and gas are trapped in orbit, forming a rotating disk or donut shape around the young star. These circumstellar disks around young stars are known as protoplanetary disks, because they provide the reservoir of materials from which new planets may form. In other words, this picture is telling us something important. New planets might be forming in the Rho Ophiuchi complex. Protoplanetary disks are thought to be made up of 99% gas and 1% dust. As planets form and stellar systems evolve, their circumstellar disks also evolve. Circumstellar disks around older stars may include dust, gas, asteroids, comets, planets, and other debris. Our Sun has several circumstellar disks: the asteroid belt, the Kuiper belt, and the Oort cloud. Stellar jets. In the early stages of a star's life, a fascinating phenomenon occurs known as stellar jets. These jets are visible as a red jet of material emanating from a dark cloud, as depicted in the right part of the picture. But what exactly are stellar jets, and how are they produced? To understand stellar jets, we first need to grasp the concept of circumstellar disks. Circumstellar disks are flat structures of gas and dust that surround a young star, similar to a spinning disk. These disks form from the gravitational collapse of a molecular cloud and play a crucial role in the formation of new planets. Just like a spinning top, the material within these disks rotates around the central protostar. Now let's delve into the mechanism behind stellar jets. As material falls onto the protostar from the surrounding accretion disk, the interaction between the magnetic fields of the rotating star and the disk causes the material to change direction. Instead of falling directly onto the protostar, some of this material is ejected outwards from the stellar magnetic poles, resulting in the formation of stellar jets. However, the accretion process onto the protostar is not always a smooth and consistent flow. Sometimes there are sudden fluctuations in the rate of material falling onto the protostar. When there is a rapid increase in the accretion rate, it leads to the formation of denser bullets of material within the jets. This progression allows scientists to directly measure their velocity, providing valuable insights into the dynamics of stellar jets. To better understand this concept, we can use an analogy. Imagine a spinning top with colorful ribbons attached to its edges. As the top spins around, the ribbons are pulled towards the center due to the rotation. However, if there are sudden bursts of energy, the ribbons might fly outwards in a jet-like manner. Similarly, in the case of a young star, as material falls into it from the surrounding disk, the interplay between magnetic fields causes some of the material to be ejected in the form of stellar jets. These jets are responsible for lighting up the molecular hydrogen present in the region. It's as if when jet particles collide with hydrogen particles, the latter switch on. In scientific terms, a strong interaction between the radio jet and molecular gas powers molecular hydrogen emission. Hey you! Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Galaxies behind the dust. This image is even more impressive once we analyze its details. For instance, have you realized the details that we can see of these galaxies through the dust of the nebula? Something that seems like science fiction when told, yet it is reality, a dream that is materializing before our eyes. But how does JWST do it? One of the most astounding features of this telescope is its ability to observe the universe in infrared wavelengths, allowing it to see through clouds that obscure the view of traditional telescopes. The advantage of observing in the infrared spectrum lies in the fact that infrared light has longer wavelengths than visible light. By harnessing the power of the infrared, the JWST is able to peer through these barriers, revealing hidden marvels and unveiling the secrets of the universe that were previously concealed. While the images produced by the Hubble may already be magnificent, they lack the ability to penetrate the layers of obscuring material. However, with James Webb, the story is completely different. Observations of the universe in infrared wavelengths provide astronomers and scientists with a level of detail that was once only conceivable in the realm of science fiction. Saturn under a new light. As you can understand, James Webb never stops astonishing us. Only a few weeks ago, it showed us Saturn under a completely different light. The image showcased an extremely dark planet. This is because at the infrared wavelengths, methane gas that makes up Saturn absorbs almost all of the sunlight falling into the atmosphere. When comparing the northern and southern poles of the planet in this image, the differences in appearance are typical of known seasonal changes on Saturn. For example, Saturn is currently experiencing northern summertime, with the southern hemisphere emerging from the darkness at the end of winter. However, the northern pole is particularly dark, perhaps due to an unknown seasonal process affecting polar aerosols in particular. Saturn is seen surrounded by its famous system of rings, and the level of detail is incredible. On the left side of the image, we can also notice three of its moons, Dion, Enceladus, and Tethys. In short, Webb's first year was one for the history books. Who knows what this incredible instrument will allow us to discover next? We will, of course, keep you updated. Make sure you don't miss any of our new videos, because the best is yet to come. So, what are your thoughts on this video? Let us know in the comments below. I'll see you next time on the channel.